Right now, though, it's Sunny and Shay, and we're here with you to discuss something that I think is very poignant and heartfelt for the Sikh community here in the United Kingdom. That's because on Tuesday on BBC One at 10:35, there will be a documentary airing, which is called Young, Sikh and Proud, in which journalist Sunny Hundal is exploring the legacy of his late brother, Jagraj Singh. Jagraj Singh is considered the most popular Sikh leader of modern Britain, who really sparked an unprecedented revival of young people returning to the faith and returning to Sikhism, not only here in this country, but internationally as well. He was the founder of Basics of Sikhi and also the founder of Everything's 13. And you'll get to hear more from Sunny Hundal as to why he has decided to do this documentary about his late brother Jagraj Singh. But we are joined first on the line by Jagraj Singh's widow, Sukhmani Kaur, who also features in the documentary. Sukhmani, it's a pleasure to have you on the show, and thank you for joining us.
Thanks for inviting me.
Sukhmani, I'd like to start off firstly to ask you to kind of put into context from your perspective what you think is the legacy of Jagraj Singh and of his work.
I think if you want to say it in one sentence, you probably will say revolutionized approach to Sikh education. And he did not only spoke to Punjabi Sikhs, he spoke to wider audience. And his aim was to reach, to bring Sikhi out into the mainstream sort of context. And the methods that he used, they were kind of unseen and even unthought of probably 10 years ago when he started. And now kind of more and more people just inspired by those methods.
And you're talking about, of course, using the World Wide Web, right? A lot of the videos we can still see are very much on YouTube, aren't they, with regards to Basics of Sikhi?
Basics of Sikhi is a YouTube channel, which was one of his projects. But not only that, even the way how he spoke, the way how he approached the subjects, analogies, you know, parallels that people from Western world can relate, rather than kind of traditional, more Punjab-based educational ways.
And then with that in mind, because I think you're absolutely right, even now, anyone tuning into the show can go to Basics of Sikhi, that's S-I-K-H-I, if you'd like further details online and on YouTube. Let's find out firstly, because I think it's important for us to put into context what, you know, the majority of the Sikh community feel is the legacy of Jagraj Singh, which must be, of course, Everything's 13 and the work that Everything's 13 do, which was started by Jagraj Singh. Just put that into context of what Everything's 13 is and what they do.
Yeah, so Everything's 13 is a Sikh educational charity that Jagraj has established back in 2012. Mm. And I explain a little bit about the meaning of the name. So Everything's 13 is actually a play on words, because 13 in Punjabi is Tera. So everything Tera. Tera means number 13 and also means yours.
Yes.
As talking to Waheguru, to God, saying everything is yours. And this was very much Jagraj's kind of mentality, that he would not ever put his name onto anything, because it was not belonging to him. It was all kind of for Sikhi and for spreading Guru's wisdom and Guru's teachings. So Everything's 13 is a Sikh educational charity which runs several projects. One which is most popular is the YouTube channel Basics of Sikhi. And at the moment, it's got over 2,000 videos. Majority of them are in English, on different aspects of faith, history, teachings, how to learn things, how to understand things, why things are done, not just telling you what to do, but also why and how, and kind of in an inspiring way. And we, Everything's 13 is international organization. So we have charities registered in UK, Canada, Southeast Asia, working on India, America, and we're working off the blueprints that Jagraj kind of left, and we're still building up on those foundations, because he had so many ideas. other project that he started is Sikh Press Association, Sikh PA. It's kind of like a hub for media and Sikh organizations to talk about, to come in contact in regards to Sikh news. They host events, do press releases for media and Sikh organizations. Also, we do children's projects, which kind of the part which I'm involved in is Mighty Khalsa and Kiddy Sangat. It's kind of to inspire the younger generation,
yes,
and bring resources to young parents for them to kind of help their kids to learn about Sikh in an inspiring and modern way.
I mean, even just listening to what you've said, Sukhmani, it's quite clear that, you know, Jagraj has left a legacy through these organisations. And, you know, as much as I'd love to spend the next 2 hours talking about it, we probably wouldn't, you know, we just wouldn't physically be able to cover everything that Jagraj Singh started off. But that said, Sunny and I have been reflecting upon when he came on the show, and when he joined us on the show, he talked about the Sikh community, his hope for unity. And I just wanted to know if you feel that that is still very much a key part of the message in, you know, the charities that have continued, including, of course, Everything's 13. Because I think for a lot of people who, let's say, have only heard of the name Jagraj Singh and have only heard of, you know, the Sikh community through what they see in mainstream press, they may not necessarily understand that that was a key message for him, this idea of unity within the Sikh community.
Absolutely. One of his main sort of philosophies was that we should not, within the community, we should not keep fighting about the 5% that divides us, all the little controversies and, you know, I agree on this, I don't agree on this, you should follow my path, no, you should follow my path. But we should unite on the 95% that we all agree upon. You know, 95%, and that keeps us on in Sikhi, keeps us on the path of Guru and Guru's teachings. And with Everything Set In and all of our projects, we always keep this kind of the in the back of our minds for anything that we do, any project, any initiatives. It's always, I don't think it would be wrong to say that Everything Set In is seen by the community as very inclusive Sikh organization.
Yeah. I think that's a fair point. You know, even for myself, having come and seen some of the events by Everything's 13, something I have to ask you, because actually we were talking to our producer about this before we came on the show today, and she hadn't heard of Jagraj Singh until, of course, this documentary, which we'll touch upon in a moment. And I was trying to explain to her the impact that Jagraj Singh had in such a short period of time. I mean, he is definitely, you know, so loved even now for many people since his death. He just, people talk about the fact that they've reconnected with Sikhism through his videos, through his messages. What is it, do you feel, was about Jagraj that was perhaps so unique or different that he managed to connect with people no matter what your age, no matter what your background, no matter if you were Sikh or not? It, you know, it didn't matter. He used to do street, you know, prakars, where he would literally meet people on the streets and talk to them, random people he didn't know, and they'd become engaged and want to know more from him. There was a charisma that he had, wasn't there?
Definitely. So you said something. You said his message. Would Jagraj would never agree with that statement.
Yeah,
it was never his message. It was always message of Guru's message. It was always Guru's message. You know, I was thinking about it. It's a little bit like Slumdog Millionaire.
Okay.
You know, when the person acquired these skills and random facts throughout his life.
Yes.
And with Jagraj, it was pretty much the same. So his path, like, you know, he learned debating and kind of presenting his views while he was at Oxford. Then when he was in the army, it was kind of organization and delegating skills. And then it all, kind of all those skills came to a culmination with in the prachar, in his, like, kind of ignited through his love for Sikhi.
Right.
And it's, I think that's what touched people's hearts, because he spoke from pure heart, from experience, with his love for the teachings.
Yeah.
And having all those skills and being able to deliver the message, that's what, you know, touched people's hearts.
Yeah, look, I agree with you on that. I think when I met him, I loved the fact, look, I'm a West Londoner. I joked with him about that, you know, very proud to be from West London. And I always loved, even in the temple, when he would talk in English, sometimes he'd relate with the youngsters by using the word in it, you know, things that you wouldn't think you would hear. Do you know what I mean? Just in terms of his use of language, I think what a lot of people, I would say from people I've interviewed over the years, is the fact that he spoke on a very basic level that everybody could understand. He articulated himself in such a way that was relatable to a lot of people. But as you say, absolutely, it was the message of Sikhism. You're absolutely right in that. Finally, of course, I must talk to you about the documentary. It's going to be airing on Tuesday. It is fair to say at this point, we've seen a lot of people on social media already airing their views who have not seen the documentary. There is people who are slightly concerned about what is going to be said regarding the Sikh community, those that are apprehensive. I'd just like to get your perspective about the documentary in terms of the Sikh community and philanthropy, because I know that is something, having seen the documentary, we'll be talking to Sunny Hundal very shortly, that perhaps maybe many people are concerned hasn't been reflected as much as it possibly could have been.
Absolutely agree here with you, because in the last years, maybe last 10 years, the growth of those seva, of those selfless service projects, you know, the philanthropical projects like homeless feeds, mental health programs, free educational centers, you know, community outreach programs, there's been a huge explosion of those. I don't know, organizations like SWORD, Khalsa Aid, they do this. And in this documentary, it has not been touched upon at all. And it could have been connected with Jagraj in the way that all those projects, the growth of them is because people learn more about Sikhi. People learn more about Sikh principles, Sikh history, and it's in the core of Sikh teachings. So it could have been great if we could have concentrated more on those positive messages about Sikh community, which you cannot deny.
I think that's one of the reasons why the whole country is going to get to hear about your late husband on Tuesday. Although I think it's understandable, as you say, that, you know, there are going to be areas that many people, and we're going to discuss it with Sunny Hundal in the next half an hour, maybe would not like to talk about or maybe are apprehensive about. Ultimately, it's about the legacy of Jagraj Singh. So thank you so much for joining us, Sukhmani. And hopefully we can get you in the studio in the future. We'd love to hear more about Mighty Khalsa and the work that you're doing there. Yeah. I'm a new mum. And so, you know, all of these kind of projects that help with children, I think are always really interesting. So we'd love to get you in the studio. But thank you so much for joining us today. We do appreciate it. That is Sukhmani Kaur, the widow of Jagraj Singh. And as you mentioned, if you'd like further details, then what I'd really recommend to do is go to the website. For her, a key point and the reason that she's only doing this interview, she's not doing any other interviews, any public interviews whatsoever on radio, is because she wanted to talk about Everything's 13. So if you'd like further details, go to the website everythings13.org. So that's Everything's 13, the number 13.org, or online you can go to the YouTube channel Basics of Sikhi. Before we do though, just take a moment. A lovely call has come through. Producer Aku has just told us. She says Jasveer Singh has called in from the Sikh Press Association, and he just wanted to say well done for a brilliant interview, Sunny and Shay, with Sukhmani Kaur and with Sunny Hundal discussing the legacy of Jagraj Singh. We really appreciate that. Thank you so much, Jasveer. On a personal note, now that the interview is done, we can say this. At the time, obviously, it was important for us to get all angles. But on a personal note for Sunny and I, Jagraj Singh was an amazing man. He really touched us. And we were really lucky to have him on the show.
We were.
So to do justice to the man that he was, it was important for us to find that balance. So getting feedback like that means a lot. Thank you for that, Jasveer. And if you would like further details and you're thinking, who is this amazing man? How did he touch, you know, so many thousands of people, not just in the country, but across the world, with his simple message of unity through Sikhism? Then we're talking about Jagraj Singh. You can watch the documentary on BBC One on Tuesday. It's called Young, Sikh and Proud.